The strongest effects of a weak Hurricane Iselle are still a couple of hours away from making landfall. But the Big Island is already feeling some effects of the storm. The Big Island's already getting rain and some strong gusts. The current track has Iselle moving up the island chain, and it's expected to hit Maui County between 9 and 10 o'clock tonight. Then it'll hit Oahu between 6 and 7 o'clock tomorrow morning, and Kauai between 4 and 5 tomorrow afternoon. Those are the forecasters' best estimates at this point and may not be exact. We have a number of reports tonight. Marissa Yamani is in Hilo. Brent Ramadna is on the Kona side of the Big Island. And Nestor Garcia is on Maui. But first, we start with Justin Cruz here at the Forecast Center. Jess?
Thanks a lot, Joe. Here's the rain situation for the Big Island. It's not raining everywhere, but there are a few areas that are seeing heavy rains. Just to the east of Waimea, it looks like there's a cell. Folks in Waimea might see a little bit of thunderstorm activity over the next 20 to 30 minutes. And also along South Hilo into the Puna District, in areas such as Mountain View, Glenwood, there are some heavy rains, and there's a flood advisory posted for that area right now. Let's take a look at the Hilo cam atop the roof of Nani Loa Hotel. What we've seen all day today is on again, off again showers. Now, sometimes we'll be able to see across the bay. Right now, it's a little shrouded, but it has been cloudy all day, and it doesn't look like there's a very heavy rain situation, although looking at the trees, it looks like winds may have started to kick up, and we'll check on those in a little bit. Continuing on, Maui County seeing a little bit of an increase in rain as well, and then lighter showers for the rest of the state. You can see that rain moving through, even also for Lanai and Molokai. Here's what we're looking at as far as the effects of the storm. Like Joe mentioned, 9 p.m. for Maui County, Oahu 6, 7 a.m., and then Kauai around 4 p.m. tomorrow. Each island will have a little bit of a different effect as far as what we're going to see from the storm. 60 to 70 mile per hour winds for the Big Island, and then those winds start getting lighter progressively as you move down the island chain. We'll have more on the track coming up later in weather. Joe, back to you.
Thanks, Jess. Kristine Uyeno has been at the Central Pacific Hurricane Center all afternoon. She joins us now with the latest from there. Chris?
Hi there, Joe. Yes, the latest forecast came out about an hour ago. The same strength and timeline are expected for Iselle. Meteorologist Chris Brenchley has been joining us all afternoon. And Chris, Justin had mentioned about the winds starting to pick up. What more can you tell us about that?
The winds on the Big Island are beginning to pick up as the outer rain bands of Hurricane Iselle reaches the eastern side of the Big Island. So there's been a fair amount of gusty winds that has been reported, and those winds will continue to increase as Iselle moves towards that direction.
And how strong could those winds be?
Forecasted for areas to get winds as high as 60 to 70 miles per hour, with gusts as high as 85 miles per hour. As the storm makes landfall on the east side of the Big Island.
And what about the other islands? What can they expect?
The rest of the island chain will expect to gradually get more winds and rain as Iselle moves west. First over Maui, later this evening we'll start to see those conditions deteriorate. Oahu early morning around maybe 6 a.m. on Friday for Oahu. And then over into Kauai on Friday afternoon, we'll start to expect the outer bands to reach there and some possibility for tropical storm force winds at that time.
Okay, and again, tropical storm force winds can be very damaging, so people should not take the winds lightly at all.
Yeah, correct. Even though we're forecasting that the hurricane will lose strength as it reaches the Big Island and moves to the west, it'll still be a tropical storm, which can contain winds of 40 and 50 miles per hour, which is very strong winds for our island chain. So there can be damage from that as well.
Okay, so Iselle maintaining the strength, but expected to slow down, expected to weaken a little bit.
Correct.
All right, thanks a lot, Chris. And we'll send it back to you, Joe.